August 9th today. It's going to be a warm day. I'm propping up some apple limbs today. The Liberty tree has got some limbs that are low limbs that I got to keep the apples out of reach of the rabbits. A lot of rabbits come, wild rabbits in the yard. So what I do is I use two fork sticks with a zip tie. I'll show you how to do that. Just put the zip tie around like that. Put the zip tie around it like that and then tighten it up. Snug, not real tight. Then you just open up the forks like that and put the limb through the top fork. So this Cortland tree over here, it's got some apples sagging down. So I'll prop this limb up. And there we go. It helps if the limbs are a little sharp on one side. They press them into the ground, but they're very sturdy that way. Wind doesn't blow them down. And you're up off the ground. So that tree should be okay. Nice thing about this method is by spreading the sticks farther apart, I can go as low as I need or as high as I need. I can even stake a limb up that's way up here. Now for a tree like this behind me, my Richelieu tree, if it has a fence around it, like this one does, it's not practical to just prop up each limb. What I'm going to try and do first is run a long stick from one edge of the fence through and underneath some limbs and out through the fence. And I'll just go around the fence like that and try and prop up the limbs that way and support it from the fence. Well, I got it half propped up. As you can see, I'm getting them propped up pretty good. I have a fork stick in the back that's holding up a high limb. This Richelieu apple falls very easily. It also shines up very nicely. And when it is red, it is really, really shiny. I'm going to taste it. So, here we go. First apple of the season. It's not ripe. Reminds me of eating green apples as a child in my grandmother's orchard. You could make a passable apple pie with it right now. I mean, the flesh isn't too crisp. It's a spitter though. The flesh is soft enough to eat, but there's a tartness and a little bit of astringency. But I can see why the deer and the rabbits are eating it. There's a lot of juice in it. As you see from the apples on the ground, the possums and raccoons and deer and stuff are knocking everything down, and I'm losing apples every night, a couple. Hopefully those are the wormier ones. But I can see by the grass being packed down in there that there's been probably possums in there. Well, I put this limb up high, but now unfortunately it's within reach of the deer. So I'm going to have to try and pull this fence out so they can't get up and over it. I'll probably prop that out with a stick. I'm just going around, propping up. I got some inner ones there that are hanging down. I got to get a fork stick on that limb there. That's got a lot of apples on it. Ooh. Might be better just to leave it hanging. If you try to prop a limb out, you know, sideways out the way it used to be, the apples are going to pull it down and break it. What you want to do on a limb, if it's bending down like this, you can put a little prop underneath it here to take the weight off, but don't try and straighten it up back the way it was. If you tried to prop this up here, then that's where it would break. A couple more, I'll be done. And there we go. Propped up all the way around. There, I put a stick out here to push the fence out. And I'll see if I can push the fence out a little bit here too. Boy. Those apples want to fall off real easy. I hope it doesn't collapse the whole fence. I'm going to have to do something with this tree. What I think I need is a large pole, like a 12-foot pole right in the center, and then tie the limbs up from the inside. Maypoling, it's called. So you rope the limbs upward to the center. Trail cameras are best located if they're out in the sunny area to be pointed to the north. So north is actually that way. That's close enough to north. I'm going to use this old pole I have here up in the orchard and point that brush it thick and point it toward this way. That's my activity. That's where I'm going to get the best pictures. And I'm pointing about northwest right now, so that'll be okay. So there's the camera looking toward the rich loo tree. And I removed the ferns and tall weeds down in front of it because the waving of the ferns, I got some out there I gotta get rid of, will give me a false reading and send the camera off. So let's see what kind of film we can get from that. The Richelieu tree is, it is very heavy with apples, but it's got weak wood. You get a tree with stronger wood that the limbs can go up on an angle without bending down so much. And that makes a better tree for a deer orchard. This Richelieu tree is just gonna be a pain, I know, for years. If I want any fruit out of it at all. The rest of the trees are pretty much crown lifted and they're pretty high. And the deer can't get all the apples. The Fuji aren't putting on much size. I didn't thin them heavily. I probably should, but they're just too high to reach. So I'll probably just get a lot of smaller Fujis from this orchard. That's okay, they all make cider. So the McCowan has a light crop, but it is what it is. The Cortland, the red court over here, has got about as heavy as a crop as I've seen on this tree, and that's not too heavy. Could it be that it's in the shade and that's what's causing a lot of it to be rather thin bearing? Yeah, could be. Wolf River are putting on a little bit of size. You know, they don't taste like much, but they're supposed to make a good apple pie, so I'll have to try them in an apple pie. But they're putting on some size. I expect the deer aren't probably as picky about what their apples taste like as I do. I mean, any apple's got to taste better than bark and buds. So even a horse apple must taste pretty sweet to a deer. I hear bumblebees out. We have a lot of coming in late summer, fall, late summer, basswood and other wildflowers are coming into bloom. So I hear bumblebees all over the orchard, which is good. That's why I like
That's why I like a lot of these wild flowers around here, because it keeps the bumblebees around and interested. So that they're here, they're laying eggs, and they're here next spring. We don't have many honeybees here in Michigan, as most of the country, I think. There's been honeybee mites and other parasites that are taking out the North American honeybee. But honeybees were imported from Europe, so there are wild honeybees native to North America that should do just fine. They just don't make honey.